Chris Haslam, cheese and cracker. Wow! Whoa!
And now for my next number, I'd like to return to the classic.
So this is Chris Haslam's solo part from Cheese and Crackers. That was probably one of the funnest things that we got to do together, and I don't know, just a fun project. Chris is definitely one of the craziest Manerium skaters. I mean, craziest skaters is just as well. The whole thing about this place, wow, that trick was insane. But the whole thing about this place was that it was an old methamphetamine lab too, which was crazy. I guess they busted the person and ended up renting it to us for pretty cheap, you know. So we had it for over 3 months, maybe four. And we were able to just put this mini ramp in there. And I don't know, everything about that place, being in Long Beach, and it's like around 7th Street and Martin Luther King, and it was just real run down. It just kind of had everything that we were kind of looking for. And that's how it all started. Chris always has just been, you know, skating with him all the time. Just sometimes can't believe things that he does when we're skating ramps and stuff. So it was pretty fun to just do a project like this with him, because I knew that he was definitely gonna do some crazy stuff. It's weird too, because he would have to leave and go to like different places. I mean, he would have to go on trips and then go back home for a while and he'd come back. So he hammered out a lot of this stuff pretty quick. He had so much footage. He's got so much stuff so fast. I don't know if it's what it is out from people from out that way, but they just seem to be able to do everything. And Chris is definitely one of those guys. So, like I said, it was insane. And it was fun. It was fun getting everybody together, getting friends over there to just kind of graffiti the wall with, you know, if you look at the background and some of the stuff on the wall, it's some pretty bad drawings, but that's what makes it good. My Garfield's back there, so. There's the nose grind pop in. First person I've seen do a switchback Smith grind on a mini ramp too. And he did the blunt late shove it too. It was the first time I've seen that. Now he does front blunt late shove it. Actually, he did that a while ago, but it's crazy how much time flies. The chopstick wall ride, that was really rad. I mean, people are gonna trip too when they get to see the stuff he's doing for the Almost video. That's gonna definitely be, hopefully we can get it out by the end of this year. Maybe at the end, or maybe at the beginning of 2012, but we're gonna try to push for this year. The past vert grind, that was nuts. And then that bike rack we set up, that was fun too. We just would find random things, even stuff I've had in storage I brought. And Chris started putting up all these, you know, he made some of those crazy contraptions of the rat trap, or I forgot what they call it, but whatever. That just ended up making the whole session that much more fun. I was just like, wow, like this is gonna be something weird and crazy. Who knows how people are gonna take it. But people ended up taking it as kind of like what we hoped for. It was just do whatever you want. Go skate a mini ramp, go skate a really mini ramp, go skate a big ramp. Basically, just go skate, set up whatever you want, and don't worry about what people say, like, oh, that was stupid, or that was ugly, or that's not cool. It's, you know, who cares what's cool? You're the one that gets to do it, they're just, some people are just jealous because they're not the ones that can do it. So even if it is something that they consider, oh, that's ugly. I mean, once they, if they can do it and they think it's ugly, then that's, you know, that's their opinion and that's cool, you know? But when people that don't even skate at all and they want to sit there and go, that was lame or that, that's just, you know, that just sucks. They should just... He hammered out a lot of this stuff pretty quick. One of my favorite tricks that he did was the nose grind nollie flip, which caught me off guard. And then he did the kickflip front nose grind way then. I mean, you see people do it now, but that was the first time I've seen it back then, you know? And I don't know, it's always fun to see that happen. That was one of the funnest experiences, like I said, to be able to skate with Haslam and watch him do some of the craziest stuff I've ever seen in skateboarding.